Greetings, everyone. Welcome to Spacing Out. I'm Maureen Ellsbury.
And I'm Alejandro Rojas. Thank you for joining us.
We're here to get you caught up on the news, so here are some of the UFO stories that have made headlines recently.
Starting around 9 p.m. on March 24, 2015, residents of the town of Connaught Chase in the UK took to the social media to post UFO sightings and reports of loud noises. Local paranormal investigator and author Lee Brickley says hundreds of witnesses were involved.
Brickley, who was a witness himself, blogged about the event as it has happened, and his account is very similar to others. He says before he could see anything, he heard a very loud noise, which reminded him of a World War II bomber. After about 3 minutes, the object came into view. He describes it as looking incredibly large and appearing astonishingly low in the sky. It was dark, so all he could see were three red lights. The object moved slowly, and Brickley thought that it was perhaps an aircraft in the process of crashing to the ground.
Brickley says the object eventually disappeared and does not believe it ended up crashing after all. He says the loud sound of the engines lasted for 5 minutes after he lost sight of the object. After the sighting, Brickley immediately went online and found that many other local residents also heard and saw the UFO, and many seemed shaken up by the event. One witness said the noise made their entire house rumble and that they were still shaking as they wrote their report.
Brickley checked with the Birmingham airport to find out if there was an aircraft in trouble, but they said they had no such reports. In his blog, Brickley noted that there was a U.S. aircraft carrier off the coast of Portsmouth, which is about 175 miles south of Cannock Chase. He speculated that perhaps they were testing a new secret space plane.
Checking up on some of the original witness reports online, there are many witnesses who are certain that what was seen were three fighter jets. Several Cannock Chase residents said that they see them often. Brickley admits this is a possibility. However, several other witnesses maintain that whatever they saw was much more mysterious than simply fighter jets.
A cosmologist recently published a paper in which he speculates about the size of extraterrestrials.
Fergus Simpson, a scientist at the Institute of Cosmos Sciences at the University of Barcelona, believes that aliens are large. As CNET explains, he used a mathematical model that assumes organisms on other planets obey the same laws of conservation of energy that are seen on Earth.
Throughout the animal kingdom, species which are physically larger invariably possess a lower population density, possibly due to their enhanced energy demands, Simpson states. He says that most inhabited planets are likely to be closer in size to Mars than Earth, which leads him to surmise that since population density is widely observed to decline with increasing body mass, we conclude that most intelligent species are expected to exceed 300 kilograms. In other words, he is speculating that most intelligent extraterrestrials are over 650 pounds.
SETI Institute senior astronomer Seth Shostak has also suggested that intelligent extraterrestrials are likely larger than humans, but he acknowledges the speculative nature of these types of studies. Duncan Forgan, an astrobiologist at the University of St. Andrews School of Physics and Astronomy, thinks Simpson's calculations are reasonable, but he criticizes the paper for failing to address the correlation between body mass and the planet's surface gravity.
Newsweek points out that we only have our planet and its inhabitants to serve as a model for what life looks like. This paper, like others, assumes that Earth is a typical or average planet and uses information from here to make assumptions about the unknown. But it's impossible to know if that's appropriate to do from a scientific point of view.
Several Californians in a neighborhood in southwest Bakersfield have reported spotting a bright blue UFO in the night sky. They say they have seen it twice, once on February 14, and then again a month later on March 14. Some of them have even captured the UFO on video. 23 ABC reporter Lindsay Adams says the neighbors believe the blue UFO is extraterrestrial.
Witnesses described the mysterious light as being very bright and blue, and some said it made weird movements in the sky before disappearing. Several witnesses also saw what appeared to be a flash of light near the object. The flash was described as looking like lightning, but one witness says he and his wife captured the flash of light on video, and it doesn't look like lightning to them. There were no clouds in the sky that evening.
Kelly Castruita says that she first spotted the light when she was taking out the trash. She told the local ABC affiliate, 23ABC, that at first she thought it was a star, but then decided it was too bright to be a star. Her husband, Jeff, also witnessed the light. He says he watched it for 10 minutes while it was doing weird stuff. He says it would turn on and off and then disappear.
Another witness, neighbor Randy Gabriel, also saw the object. He said the object was moving, but then it stopped and moved up and down. He says he never saw anything like it.
Another neighbor who saw the object, Ricardo Pantoja, says he is used to seeing helicopters and airplanes fly by, but that the blue UFO was nothing like that. He also says he does not believe the UFO was a drone because it would have been too big. Kelly Castruita agreed with Pantoja. She says it was too high in the sky to be a drone.
Adams took the videos to the Kern County Sheriff's Department, who works closely with the local airport. Senior Deputy Victor Kesey told Adams that they had not received any calls regarding the blue lights. However, looking at the video, he says he seldom, if ever, has seen anything like it. He did note that we are in the age of drones and suggested it could be a military or civilian drone.
23ABC also got in touch with Edwards Air Force Base, which is about 80 miles southwest of Bakersfield. The base says they had not received any calls about the light and suggested it could be a possible aurora in the sky or testing from Vandenberg.
A Georgia witness in Moultrie with a military background reported watching a cigar-shaped UFO being followed by a black helicopter. And this is according to testimony in case 63045 from the Mutual UFO Network's witness reporting database.
The witness says he spent 6 years in the military, with four of those working with special operations. He says he has seen every type of aircraft and helicopter each branch has, but at 11:10 p.m. on February 2nd, he witnessed a craft that he could not identify.
The witness says he stepped outside to smoke a cigarette and stare at the stars when he noticed a small cigar-shaped silhouette with four bright lights moving from the north to the south. He says the two lights in the middle were bigger and brighter than the others, and he provided MUFON with two illustrations of what he saw.
The witness then says he noticed the object was being followed by a Black Hawk or Jayhawk helicopter, both of which are very similar. He says he could tell the type of helicopter by the lights on the tail.
About halfway through the sighting, the witness says the lights on the UFO got very bright for about 10 seconds, then dimmed back down, and neither aircraft made a sound.
As we previously reported, John Burroughs, a witness to the UK's most famous UFO encounter, was able to get the UK government to admit they had not released all of their UFO files as they had previously claimed. In December 2013, in response to a Freedom of Information request, they said they had found 18 UFO files they would send to the UK National Archives for public release, but that has not happened yet. And a member of the UK House of Lords wants to know why.
Lord Black of Brentwood, a member of the House of Lords and part of their Information Committee, formally asked the UK government the status of the release of these files. In a message titled Unidentified Flying Objects that was posted on the UK Parliament's written question and answer page on March 2, 2015, Lord Black writes, "To ask Her Majesty's government whether the 18 Ministry of Defence unexplained flying object files that have yet to be released to the public have been passed from the Ministry of Defence to the National Archives. What is their current estimate of when the National Archives will make the files public and whether the files will be released in a single batch or in multiple batches?"
In December 2013, Burroughs was told in a response to his FOI request that the UK Ministry of Defence, also known as the MOD, found 18 UFO files that had not been released in their effort initiated in 2008 to release all of their UFO files. Burroughs was told that the files would need to be prepared and sent to the UK National Archives for release. In September 2014, the MOD mentioned the UFO files again on their FOI website, but said they still had not sent them to the UK National Archives.
Lord Black's recent request was answered on March 10, 2015 by Lord Astor of Hever, who is also a member of the House of Lords and serves as the House of Lords Parliamentary Under Secretary for the Ministry of Defence. Lord Astor wrote, "None of the 18 Ministry of Defence unexplained flying object files have been passed from the MOD to the National Archives for release. The MOD is working with the National Archives to facilitate the transfer, which we estimate will be in the next 9 to 12 months. The release mechanism will then be agreed between the MOD and the National Archives," which is, that's a kind of an extreme timeline. 9 to 12 months to get these files transferred over to release to the public, and this has been going on for a while. They keep stalling. Yeah.
It's crazy. I mean, December 2013, they say they're going to transfer them. September 2014, we find out they haven't, and they're still going to. Now they say it's going to take months to transfer them and then months to process them. So it may be a year or two. I mean, years will pass by between when they told Burroughs they would release the files to when they're releasing them. And there's no explanation as to why. I mean, people watching the show know we're not really conspiracy-minded so much, but this does smack of a conspiracy. I mean, Nick Pope, I think, has said that as well. This is really weird. Why are they not releasing these files?
Just 18, and who knows what are in them. We're going to get them, and they're going to be super boring, and nothing's going on.
Yeah.
Or there may be something that they're trying to figure out. How do we release this without, you know, kind of covering their tracks in regards to what the files contain? Could be either way.
Yeah.
But yeah, it sure has conspiracy theorists up in arms.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
All right. This is ridiculous.
Alejandro's angry about
Release these files.
That's all for this episode of Spacing Out. As always, remember to visit our website, which is openminds.tv, for all the latest UFO news. And you can follow us at Twitter at openmindsTV.
Let us know if you enjoyed today's episode by liking the episode on YouTube and leaving us your comments in the section below. You can also download our podcast, Open Minds UFO Radio, on iTunes or at openminds.tv/radio. Thanks again for joining us today. I'm Alejandro Rojas.
And I'm Maureen Ellsbury. We will see you in the future.